Well, to have a Finals MVP come back to your team, Steph Curry again.
Oh! Curry's got 25 and just gave us the shimmy.
But the crowd is stunned and buzzing with Steph Curry.
What's wrong with that?
Why are they stunned? They should be used to these type of performances.
They haven't been here though, Reggie.
Condition is amazing.
So Curry had that 25-point first quarter. Golden State led by 19 in the first half, and then a 25-5 run by Paul George and the Clippers, and they take their first lead, and they're up 67-66 at the break.
Oh, sure.
Yo, what's good, y'all? So I want to dive right into this topic, right? Because last night was a great game between the Warriors and the Clippers. Steph Curry was balling out. Mostly in the first quarter, you know what I mean? And the Warriors wound up getting the win. But I want to talk about how that game taught me two things for a fact, which I already knew this, by the way, but it just reminded me, I should say. So, number one, man, Ty Lue is the best coach in the NBA. Ty Lue is the best coach in the NBA, right? Let's just call it what it is. So, if y'all recall, coached the Cavaliers to that 3-1 comeback on Golden State. He coached the Clippers to that 3-1 comeback last season on the Mavs. I mean, against the Mavs. He has a history of being able to adjust to what's going on in a playoff series or what's going on throughout a game in order for his team to come back and win. Or at least come back and be competitive again, which a lot of coaches don't do, because a lot of coaches will just give up hope and say, oh, we'll just fix this next game. I'ma just fuss these guys out after the game. I'ma just cuss these guys out, blame it on them as to why we couldn't execute down the stretch. But what Ty Lue does is he always stays calm. Look at his face when he's going through it, when he's down bad, when his team is losing crazy. The Warriors were up by like 19 points early on. I mean, social media was already going crazy, right? Steph Curry, this and that. The Warriors are back at it, which they are. The Warriors are back looking good already. Before they even get Clay back, before they even get their young players to start hopping into the system, what's going on for real. Jordan Poole is looking like, you know what I'm saying, he's looking so good that they might as well just get rid of Andrew Wiggins. For real. But the point is this though, right? So, yeah, just like Ty Lue stays calm when he's going through adversity, because he knows what he has to do. He knows that adversity means that you have to adjust to what's going on and just continue until the end, because the game is not over. The series is not over. So the Clippers wound up losing the game by 3 points, but they weren't even supposed to be in that position based on what was going on early on, because they were getting blown up. So what happens is this, right? The reason why I say Ty Lue is the best coach in the NBA is because he can adjust to whatever is going on against him. He can use his players. He knows how to utilize his talent on his team, right? So this goes into my next point. Paul George is a top 10 player in the NBA. But the problem is the way he plays, most coaches don't know how to use that type of player. They don't understand that that type of player needs a rhythm. They need the ball in their hands. And you have to allow them to create the offense for you, right? And let everything flow through them. This is why the Clippers are still going to be competitive even without Kawhi Leonard. Because Paul George, being a top 10 player, he's getting used the right way by Ty Lue. So they're going to be able to compete against anybody, bro. People can't drive, bro. He's become probably the most underrated player in the league. It's between him and Kyrie, right? Because now you got people that think Paul George can't play basketball. You got people that think Paul George is just some type of average, like 85 overall type of scorer, right? Like he's just Paul George. No, Paul George has been a top 10 talent in the league since he was in Indiana, bro. He has. And if you don't understand what I'm talking about, you're going to have to watch more Paul George highlights and footage of what he be doing on the court. So, you know what I'm saying? Paul George is 6'8", 6'9". I really think he's 6'10". And his ability to do it all on the court is unlike anything we've seen. He has probably the best handles for somebody his size ever. He can score all three levels. at an elite level. He's very athletic. He can defend. You know, he's a great defender. He's more talented than Kawhi Leonard. He is. He just is. Why? See, everything is not disrespect to a player, bro. I bet you Kawhi Leonard will say that. He'll be like, yeah, Paul George, nice as fuck. Paul George is better than me. That's what Kawhi Leonard would say. So what you have is a perfect storm in the West. The Clippers are going to surprise a lot of people this year because they feel as though, and I'm not saying they're going to go, they're going to be better without Kawhi, but they're going to be, it's like this, right? They're going to have a better system without Kawhi. But they wouldn't be scarier than they are with Kawhi. Because we got both of those guys, Kawhi and PG, the firepower is just too overwhelming sometimes. But you have a better system when it's just one of them. And I feel like they're better with just PG than they would be with just Kawhi, because PG is a more natural scorer. He's a more natural playmaker, a natural shooter. You know what I mean? He's more natural at these things, instincts. He doesn't have, like, specific spots on the court. You know what I'm saying? He doesn't have specific spots on the court to where he has to get there. Those are the spots where he can be most effective. That's kind of what Kawhi Leonard is. I love Kawhi Leonard, but Paul George can operate from anywhere. It's kind of like a tall-ass Kyrie, or a tall, a really tall, like CJ McCollum, right? Or Dame. You know what I mean? You got to think about it that way. You know, it's the reason why Kevin Durant said Paul George is his favorite player. But yeah, man, you got the best coach in the NBA and the top 10 talent in the NBA. And that best coach in the league knows how to use that player. So the Clippers are going to do something this season as far as exceeding people's expectations, right? A lot of people are going to be surprised. I don't know if him getting stepped over by Allen Iverson sort of like taught him how to overcome adversity. But he definitely knows how to do it. He knows that he's been in worse positions before. Ty Lee was literally laying on the ground after getting crossed over. He was laying on the ground watching Allen Iverson's shot swish after Allen Iverson had just crossed him over in the NBA Finals, right? And before you can get up, Allen Iverson is stepping over you. He's literally stepping over you like you something in his way on the street. Oh, I'm going to step over you real quick. Get out of my way so I can get back on defense. And then you got to get back on defense. That's a bad position to be in. And, you know, but what did he do that game, though? See, Ty Lue helped his team, helped the Lakers win that game back in the day, because he wasn't even worried about that, right? He kept going. He kept playing good defense on Allen Iverson to make sure that whatever it is that Allen Iverson is doing, it doesn't even matter, because we're going to win the game. Do you feel what I'm saying? So, think about last season when Luka Doncic was going nuts on the Clippers. Ty Lue had the same mentality then. When a team is fucking up Ty Lue's team, all Ty Lue was thinking about is when Allen Iverson stepped over him. It can't compare to that. That's why Ty Lue is the best coach in the league. You know what I'm saying? That's why. Steve Kerr is one of the best coaches. Steve Kerr is one of the best coaches in the league because Jordan banged the shit out of him. Jordan punched him in practice or whatever happened. You know, he got dropped by he got dropped a couple times too. See, adversity is gonna teach you how to succeed. Adversity is gonna teach you what you gotta do to improve. To get out of your situation, right? You gotta understand this shit, bro. But yeah, man. You got Ty Lue, you got Paul George. Killers. So let me know what y'all think about this video. Let me know what y'all think about the Clippers and Ty Lue and Paul George. You know what I'm saying? Crunch Time Podcast. We out here getting better every day, bro.